welcome to another episode of Cultural Magazine, where we bring you the latest cultural events taking place around the nation. Our cameras are always following them. Let's go take a look at today's episode. Sculptor Galel Gumaya is a celebrity sculptor. He started his artistic career in the 1980s, where he sculpted regular statues out of stone. Then in the 1990s, he started working with wire. And this exhibition, which is called The Beauty of the Creatures, Gemal El Kainat, is actually a collective work of his entire career. He shows from each phase of his artistic career since the 90s, since he started working with wire, a piece, and he exhibited it here. Actually, they are really beautiful. If we look at them, the beautiful bulls, the horses, and the various animals he depicted out of wire. And although it is out of wire, yet it's quite graceful and beautiful. Now let's get to know more about him and learn more about his work.
بالنسبة لاستخدام الأسلاك هي حاجة جديدة فكل الناس الحقيقة كانت بتستغربها يعني إيه اللي بيعمل نحت ده بسلك
When I started working with wire, people were amazed and surprised. It was a new style of art in Egypt to sculpt with wire. The people became curious about it and came to learn from me how to work with wire. They found that wire sculptures contain details as well as the need to know about the anatomy of the body. They found it interesting, and as the days passed, more artists came to me to teach them that new genre of sculpture. I started holding wire sculpture workshops for children at the Cairo Opera House. I taught children up to the age of 17. Each workshop was concluded with an art exhibition for the work sculpted by the students. And then I started receiving course requests from adults and professional sculptors. I was even approached by accessory designers who felt that learning such a technique would enrich their work. So this art started spreading and more people came to learn. Now four of my students are professional artists and I'm really proud of them. So I invited them to exhibit their works as part of my exhibition to introduce them to the public. It took me years of experimentation and hard work to master sculpting with wire. Now it's like drawing with pencil or drawing a sketch. Now it's all about the wire, the needle, my imagination, and of course, taking in consideration studying the features of the piece to be sculpted before working on it.
جلال الجمعة تجربتي بيه مش 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 رسم ولا 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 النحت، لأن هو النحت سكة غير الرسم.
Jalal Juma is a good friend of mine. He made me a beautiful portrait of wire. Jalal observes his subject's facial features and analyzes it. He even photographed me to study my features before he made the wire statue of my portrait, and he made an exquisite piece of art for me.
Caricature is the pulse of the society, and the caricaturists, they through their work reflect the various aspirations as well as also the hopes and challenges facing that society in a humorous way, of course. And right now, let's enter the world of cartoonist and caricaturist Mr. Mohammed Hakim.
هو الكاريكاتير مهم جدا لان احنا شعبنا اصلا شعب ساخر والكاريكاتير بياخد السخريه اكتر من اي حاجه ثانيه.
Caricature is very popular in Egypt, as we are humorous people. We love humor. Some people think that caricature is based on jokes, but this is not true. It is important to know how to deliver your thoughts in a simple yet innovative way. Political and social caricature are called editorial cartoons. They are also called political cartoons. It is an illustration containing a commentary that usually relates to current events or personalities. Editorial cartoons vary from one country to another, depending on the people, their culture, and their concerns. Egypt has its own concerns, and it has its own culture. We are an agriculture-based society. We have a long ancient history, starting from Pharaonic up till modern times. The future of cartoon is more associated with the future of paper media prints rather than the online media. It was created to be drawn on paper, and that is why it endures longer, while viewing it on the computer is a temporary thing. You cannot even detect the quality of it. Is it good art or simply photoshopped?
Cultural Magazine's cameras are always following the latest events taking place around the nation from different art forms such as photography, painting, music. We go and follow it. Let's take a look at the cameras and what they captured. A number of photographers took themselves around a tour in the African continent where they went to several African countries and took pictures of the wildlife and animals around the African continent to display the beauty of Africa. They entitled this exhibition Wildlife 2016. Let's go take a look at the pieces they took.
This is our second African wildlife exhibition in Egypt. Last year we was in Zambia. We made the same time last year. There was an exhibition here in the same place for our first trip to Africa. And this is our second one. This time is different actually. We are more photographers is joining us. Last year was only 4 photographers. Now we are 9 in this exhibition. Hopefully next year we will be more. Trying to extend this culture, African culture, trying to extend the culture of photographing wildlife, traveling to Africa. It's just amazing places to visit. Here today we are exposing 40 photos for 9 photographers, exceptional photos we have chosen. We are working on this exhibition for almost a month now. Continuously we are working on it, and hardly to get this display to make everybody enjoy the sea. I'm really happy just to see everybody is watching us. It's watching our photos, is enjoying it. Hopefully we will be going bigger. Hopefully we can extend this culture everywhere. Wildlife photography is actually, it's adventure. It's adventure. There is a risk everywhere. There is no guarantee we can get the photos we want. There is no guarantee we can reach our target. Even in 10 days, in 15 days, there is no guarantee for anything. Animals come and go, no rules. There is no rules of it. We have to stay on camps, on the bark itself. Animals just around us, we have to sleep there. Every day we have to take chances to get our photos. Sometimes we get it, sometimes we don't. But this is wildlife photography, there is no guarantee in anything. In this exhibition this year, we have some different photos. It's not only animals or birds. There is culture photos, which people, we can show people, this Maasai Mara people from Kenya. We are trying also to make this bigger, to deliver the culture to everybody here. Photos has no rules, has no language. Photos can be understood everywhere, can be communication between all people, everywhere, with no language. It's the language itself. The photo is the language itself. We are showing you the beauty of God made. We are showing you the beauty of creatures. We are not only creatures on the planet. There is other creatures. We are showing it. We are delivering it from Africa, from far places. Bring it here to everybody. Be easy to see it. Will be easy to ask about anything about it. We are talking about photojournalism and we are a wildlife photography. It's actually very close to each other. There is no guarantee also for anything. There is risk everywhere on it. One shot, it will not come back. If you take one shot, you cannot repeat it. You cannot try again. There is no chances on it. It's only one time. As bears, the biggest organization in photography, they put photojournalism and nature photography or wildlife photography as the hardest type of fields of photography, either photojournalism or wildlife photography. There is no big difference. The only difference that for wildlife, we have to travel to other countries, to other places, far places, away from people, away from cities, away from everyone, so we can see the animals. Photojournalism is, it's between the people itself. We'll be right back.
In this exhibition, we have nine Egyptian wildlife photographers. They took us into the African wilderness. They brought pictures of mostly all the creatures there in Kenya. And inshallah, I'll be with them in their next trip this year, inshallah. On the other hand, in Egypt, we have the bird watching tourism is one of the most common tourism in Egypt, in the ecotourism of Egypt. We have like 490 species of birds. A lot of people come from Europe to watch the birds and inside the Western Palearctic region. It's a region that contains Europe and the North African. And as we have the southern part of Egypt is almost in the Afrotropic region, so some birds can come from the African tropic species can come into the Western Palearctic region. So they come to watch them here in Egypt and Aswan, Abu Simbel, Halaib, and Shalatin. From time to time, we are organizing some bird watching and photography trips for the Egyptian inside Egypt through Fotokhana and Wildlife Masri.
Art is an up-and-coming art form here in Egypt, and a lot of Egyptians are starting to become interested in this art form. And for this reason, a lot of exhibitions are displaying different kinds of work of visual arts. So our cameras decided to go capture them. Let's go take a look.
Ela Nigm, a talented visual artist and painter who's deeply interested in women and their emotions, and in her exhibition Zat al-Haya, Self, the Essence of Life, in 35 paintings made out of different materials and different styles of art, she managed to express the emotions, the female emotions of women. Now let's enter her world.
أنا خريجة 2003 كلية تربية فنية. ده المعرض الشخصي التاسع.
I graduated from the Faculty of Fine Arts in 2003. I have taken part in many group exhibitions. This is my ninth private exhibition. Also, I have held many exhibitions abroad. I traveled to the United States, Greece, Hungary, and Paris. The Paris Autumn Exhibition was my first international one. In my works, I'm interested in women issues, female issues, problems, hopes, and aspirations. In my first exhibition, I used black and white colors, as life was either black or white, right or wrong, no gray shades. Then I started adding red color to my work. I even held an exhibition entitled Red Spots. For me, it was the color of anger and rebellion. I continued holding exhibitions with public and general themes till 2010. That's when I felt it was time to start working on women's inner feelings and concerns, and that was the theme of my 2014 exhibition, The Other. It was about the other side of ourselves. the part that we might not acknowledge but exists within us and surfaces only at certain moments. And that's when I started painting in colors to be able to depict emotions and feelings. And in today's exhibition, I continue exploring the inner emotions of women, her feelings and state of mind, her tenderness, love and care, her moods when happy, sad or angry at her lover. All these feelings I expressed in my paintings and more. I used colors to express my moods. Also, I painted three portraits of myself in different moods as well. I took several photographs of myself in different moods and psychological states. I studied and observed them. Then I painted them on canvas. I like using acrylic colors. They give richness to the paintings. I did not know that my colors were gay and cheerful. I did not plan to paint in certain colors. I left my mood choose for me, and it came out cheerful as I'm in a happy phase of my life, a phase filled with love.
From 2011, Ala was starting as she was doing graphic and silk screen style. It is not easy style for painting. She was using a motif and a repetition in her painting. Ala converted her style, as we are seeing today, into a portrait. And if we're talking first about the techniques of the images and the painting here, she's using a huge scales, and this is not easy actually for a painter. And I think she started to convert her style into a way different than the repetition of the motifs. She was using a small motifs and repeated it into in her painting. Now she started to use one figure in a bigger scale. So I think she is going to a new level in the next time. If we saw the most of the painting here, she using a portrait, and she reflect her emotion actually in each image. Even she have, I think, three self portrait here, but she even the other models, she, as I was talking with Ala, she convert her her own emotion into a different models. So she using a very hot color in most of the images, and also we can see the blues and a cool color in another one. But actually, she used a very difficult Pantone from the greens and the orange. This is not easy. And we can see also she start to use the same motifs also to decorate in the finaling, in the dressing of the portrait. Because her style is repetition of the motif. I think Ala, she's starting to follow photographers and photography in the last 5 years, and I think she will start to do photography in next year, as she told me. Actually, she start to use the two lighting direction, one from the left and the other one from the back, and we can see this is the reflection of the lighting in the models, even in the clothes and the fabrics. And I think she do it by painting in a very nice way, actually. But if we look to most of the painting, she used, I can say it's like a photography lighting. And it is, you know, it's all the arts photography is, yeah, the painter who study and learn photography, he can use the lighting by a perfect way, actually. I mean, we can see in the most of the painting, the lighting and shadow is perfect. Even her solo portrait, the main image of the exhibition. Thank you.
Ala is a very unique artist. She's, I would say, she's multi-talented. She's a designer, she's a painter, and she's a graphic artist. And she mixed all of this in this unique expression. I'm following her art ages ago, even she's young. But now she's exploding, she's putting very bright colors, and she's using her experience of graphic, putting it in painting. While you're going to make a big portrait, you are in very sensitive situation, because it could be close to posters, close to ads. But she's a painter inside, so using colors, using layers, using her experience of isolation, a background and foreground, without you feel it's a poster or something like this. So it's really a very, very interesting journey, and very bright colors, very good her talent. She escaped from putting herself in a frame. She's using all her experience, putting a feeling, an emotion, and this is very important. It's not only a beautiful painting, it's not a beautiful graphic, it's also have emotion inside. You seeing the way the models looks, and also she repeat some portraits of her, and putting herself. I would say all artists, when they making models or making portraits, they putting some of their portraits in their painting, and you seeing this in Ala's work. Also her black and whites. Her black and whites reminds me with the early photographs. It's having no tones. It's only black and white. Half tones is very, very few, because she's a graphic design, graphic arts first of all, and this is very, very, very special. Especially, you feel the black and white and the color is the same theme, not isolated, not a gap between both of them.